Hello, I'm Sam Chanter, and this is my Grade 5 project on a famous Australian. I've chosen one of Australia's most well-known comedians, Shaun Micallef.
Shaun Patrick Micallef was born here in the Adelaide suburb of Montenegro in 1962. My research uncovered this rare photo of Shaun taken in 1960. His parents Valentina and Rudyard seen he immigrated to Australia in 1943 to escape persecution by the Nazis. Shaun's father worked as a lumberjack during the day and taught ballet classes at night. His mother worked as an army nurse at East Montenegro during the day and took English lessons at night. Rudyard loved a nice haircut, as this picture of Shaun's three sisters shows, Lisa, Maggie and Thelma. Even though times were tough, the Micallef family had lots of laughs thanks to Shaun's uncles, Clown Laurie and Arthur, professional clowns known as the four Micallefs less one. Arthur passed away in 1968 and the act became the four Micallefs less two. It was the influence of Shaun's uncles that led him into comedy. During the summer months, to help the family, Shaun worked at a local banana plantation. It was here he discovered his ability as an impersonator, seen here in this photo taken in the summer of 71. Valentina and Rudyard were very proud. The following year he worked picking peaches, then a pineapple plantation, and a kiwi fruit farm. His impersonations of fruit became widely known and he even made it into the local papers. With his love for performing reaching new heights, he decided it was time to try his impersonations in America. The trip to America did not go as planned. On arrival at LAX, Shaun broke into one of his favourite impersonations, a ripe quince. He was immediately arrested by Department of Agriculture officers and spent the entire 2 weeks of his visa in quarantine. He returned to Australia, soured by the whole experience, and vowed never to impersonate fruit again. During his time in jail, he did develop a new impersonation that won him the best ball boy at the Adelaide Tennis Challenge. Valentina and Rudyard were very proud. Again.
Shaun Micallef is married with three children. His wife's name is Leandra and they were married in 1988. There are no photos of Leandra Micallef existing and many believe that she is just a product of Shaun's imagination. Shaun Micallef's children do exist because I have met them, but I am not allowed to reveal their name and I do not have a picture of them. So I asked my little brother to draw a picture of them for me. And I will refer to them as A, B and C. A, B and C.
Welcome everyone to the 1967 Adelaide Comedy Festival, this year coming to you live from the Adelaide Cultural Centre. And we're going to talk to the youngest contestant in this year's competition, a young Shaun Micallef. Hello young Shaun, and tell us, what do you want to be when you grow up?
Tim Conway.
And tell us, what's a Tim Conway?
About 125 pounds.
Oh, fantastic Shaun. And do you have any more jokes for us?
I've got a knock knock one.
Oh, how does that go?
Knock knock.
Who's there?
Cows go.
Cows go who?
No, cows go moo.
Oh, very good, young Shaun, and thank you very much. We're going to be seeing you playing your little clarinet a little bit later on. So now, it's over to Act One.
Even as a small boy, Shaun loves comedy, as he is shown on this rare film footage.
In September 1969, and US President Richard Nixon has just ordered the resumed bombing of North Vietnam. But here in sunny Adelaide, young Shaun Patrick McAuliffe is making his mark on the world of comedy. And here's young Shaun practicing his Jerry Lewis routine. Watch out, Shaun! Oh, and look who else has popped in. It's comedy legend Mr. Groucho Marx, courtesy of young Shaun Micallef. Shaun practices his Groucho for about 12 hours every day. He goes shopping with his mum and dad dressed as Groucho. That's dedication for you. And if that isn't enough, here's young Shaun doing his impersonation of Jerry Lewis drinking a glass of lemonade as the Nutty Professor. Oh dear, look at that, lemonade all down his clothes. Oh well, Mum, crank up the Hills voice, there's going to be washing to dry today. But one thing is for sure, we haven't seen the last of young Shaun Micallef.
Shaun's lemonade drinking did come in handy, as shown here.
Horse lemonade? I didn't want this.
Do not get mad. Taste new, better than ever. Hall's lemonade. If you love your usual lemonade, you haven't tasted new Hall's.
New Hall's lemonade now has an extra tangy taste for even more refreshment. Don't discover it by accident.
Do you still want your money back?
Terrific. I'll have another Hall's.
Love your lemonade. Taste new Hall's. Stay cool.
I recently caught up with Shaun and asked him a few questions about being famous.
Someone said fame is the advantage of being known by people of whom you yourself know nothing and for whom you care little. What do you think of that?
Well, Sam, that's a very good quote. I don't know who said that, but that's sort of true in some respects, I suppose, because when I was young, like when I was about your age, and I was very shy, you know, I was a very shy kid, and it was easy to stand up and be silly in front of them and not have to actually talk to them individually, you know, so I ended up talking to a group of people instead of one person each, and that sort of made it easier for me. So that's true, because you don't actually, they get to see you, but you don't really have to see them. But as I've gotten older, and I disagree with the last bit of it, I suppose, because I do actually care about the audience, and I make sure that they try and go away feeling a little bit better about themselves and about, you know, life, so they go away a bit happy rather than go away feeling, you know, I'm there for them, they're not there for me. Yep.
Someone also said before, a man can wake up and find himself famous, he has to wake up and find himself. Is that why you changed from law to comedy?
Yeah, I guess so. I guess I'd always wanted to see whether I could be a comedian. Or I wanted to be a writer originally, because I thought that was the sort of thing that I would end up doing. And yeah, it's very true. I don't think I really knew who I was until I decided to try this new thing. And if I hadn't tried it, then I guess I would always be a lawyer. I guess that's what I think I was. Maybe I wouldn't have been happy being a lawyer.
What is the most important thing in your life and why?
The most important thing in my life is my family, and they are the most important thing because I love them very much, and all the other things that I do are important but not as important.
Do your children find you funny?
Well, they pretend to, I think. No, they laugh a lot. No, we have lots of laughs, but it's not like me doing a show for them or anything. We just laugh a lot at silly things. But before I had a family, before I had children, I used to think being a comedian was the most important thing in the world, and it's sort of the second most important thing in the world.
When was the last time you cried and why?
Oh, I cry a lot. I cry at films a lot. I'm just trying to remember for you. It was probably watching a film. One of my favourite films is called It's a Wonderful Life, which your dad would probably know. But you should have a look at it too, because it's a really good film. It's directed by a man called Frank Capra, and it's a very sentimental film. And it's about a man who always put himself second, you know, for his brother or for his family or for his community. And then one day he gets so depressed that he says he's going to end it all, and he jumps off a bridge, and then an angel comes down and says, you know what life would have been like if you hadn't been around? Because he doesn't think he's made a big difference in life. He says, you know what life would have been like if you hadn't been around? Have a look at it. He says, here's what life would have been like if you'd never been born. And you see the whole town all his friends and everything, and they're all depressed and the town's terrible, and it's quite a sad film, but it's also a very, very uplifting ending. So that's probably the last time.
How has Australia benefited by your existence?
Oh dear, well that's right on topic, isn't it? That's like the angel coming in and asking me. I don't know, I don't think I'm a very important man, Sam. I think that when I was your age, I was writing about Albert Einstein and the people who actually made a difference in the world. I think if I've made any difference at all, it might be that I've made some people laugh when they might not have laughed occasionally, which is not a bad thing. Yeah.
Do you have a goal that you want to achieve, and if so, what is it?
I think all comedians are trying for that perfect laugh, you know, and a perfect laugh is one that really makes everybody laugh in the audience at exactly the same time. And that's the biggest, then you get the biggest laugh you can get. It's a big explosion of laughs. And I think I've probably been lucky enough to hear that about maybe a handful of times in my life. And it's a sweet sound, Sam. If you're interested in comedy, that's what you're after all the time. Try and get as many of those as possible.
How would you like to be remembered?
I think it depends on who's doing the remembering. I think I like my children to remember me as a good father, and I like my wife to remember me as a good dad. My friends, a good friend, and those who just know me from doing telly or on the radio, sort of a nice person who made them laugh.
Thank you.